The term panic hardware refers to a latching device that has a touchpad or crossbar which spans across at least half the width of the door and releases the latch when force is applied in the direction of egress travel. Panic hardware may also be called an exit device or a crash bar, and for fire doors, fire exit hardware. This hardware is typically used where required by code to enable large groups of people to exit quickly, but it may also be used where increased durability and reliability are needed. Panic hardware is listed in accordance with UL 305, the standard for panic hardware, and is used on doors that are not fire rated. Fire exit hardware is a type of panic hardware that is tested and listed for use on fire door assemblies, in addition to the UL 305 listing. The dogging feature, which allows the latch to be manually held retracted, is not supplied on fire exit hardware because fire doors must have an active latch bolt to keep the door closed and latched during a fire. Electric latch retraction may be used to electrically dog the latch on fire exit hardware, but the latch must project automatically upon actuation of the fire alarm. The International Building Code, the IBC, the International Fire Code, the IFC, and Nfpa 101, the Life Safety Code, are the most common building codes and fire safety codes used in the United States. It is important to know which code and which edition of that code applies to a particular facility, because the requirements for panic hardware and fire exit hardware differ depending on the code. By the way, these requirements only affect doors that lock or latch. Panic hardware is only required by code for a few occupancy types. Let's define these occupancy types first. Generally speaking, an assembly occupancy is a building or area where large groups of people gather, like a theater or gymnasium. An educational occupancy is a school for children up to 12th grade. College classroom buildings are considered business occupancies, not educational. But some college classrooms are large enough to be classified as assembly occupancies. NFPA 101 includes a separate occupancy classification for daycare occupancies, which is an area where daycare is provided to adults or children. High hazard occupancies, or areas of high hazard contents, are areas that are prone to explosions. Beginning with the 2006 editions of the IBC and the IFC, and continuing through the most recent edition, panic hardware or fire exit hardware is required for egress doors serving assembly or educational occupancies with an occupant load of 50 people or more. For high hazard occupancies, panic hardware is required regardless of the occupant load. Prior to the 2006 edition, the IBC and IFC required panic hardware or fire exit hardware for egress doors serving assembly or educational occupancies with an occupant load of 100 people or more, and for some high hazard occupancies. NFPA 101 requires panic hardware for doors serving assembly, educational, and daycare occupancies with an occupant load of 100 people or more, and for areas with high hazard contents that have an occupant load of more than 5 people. The codes include an exception for the main entrance of assembly occupancies of a limited size, which may sometimes be equipped with key-operated locks instead of panic hardware. Code requirements typically prohibit the installation of any other type of lock on a door with panic hardware, with the exception of electromagnetic locks released by a sensor or by a switch in the panic hardware. Some rooms containing electrical equipment are required to have panic hardware or fire exit hardware to allow a technician to escape if there is a fire or explosion. NFPA 70, the National Electrical Code, now requires panic hardware or fire exit hardware on doors within 25 feet of the required working space for equipment with more than 600 volts, equipment with more than 800 amps. Local codes may have different requirements for those addressed in this video, and the authority having jurisdiction, the AHJ, has the final say. To watch more videos, visit our training page at www.allegion.com/US.